The Zoom H2N has been the industry's bestseller for a long time now. If you've been working with the Google Jump, you might have got one of those in the package. The Zoom H2N is easy to operate, it's cheap, and it brings great results. It's recording on 4-channel ambisonics. And if you happen to have an older version of one of those, make sure to go to the Zoom's website and update the version, because the newer version makes it easier to record on spatial format, and it will save you a need for conversion. I would also recommend getting the toolkit that comes with it, because the wind protector is essential. Also, mind how you locate or connect the recorder to the camera, especially if your shot is moving, because if the recorder will be wobbly, it will kill your sound. Let's go over setup to see more.
Start with the Zoom H2N. First things first, bring your wind protector. And another thing that it's important to know about the Zoom, it's connecting just like a camera screw, just like these guys. So it is sometimes really hard to locate it on your tripod because it's facing up. On the GoPro cameras, so you have that space, and this guy comes with the package all the time, so it has that designated place. But in other times, it's kind of like, where do I put it on? And just the one solution that you will find to it, make sure that it's steady, because if it will move, it will ruin the sound. And I think this is the majority of the places where my staff fell, is because I would locate the microphone somehow to the tripod, but then it will move it will kill it. All right, so just pay attention to that. But for this example, we're just gonna put it on a tripod and have the dead cat on top. Turning it on. Now, we go to menu. You don't have to do it every time, but we're showing you how to do it. We're going to record. You press, and then you go in 1, 2, 3, 4 down, and you'll find special audio. And you press, and then you make sure it's on. Now, we see that the bars are moving, and then press record.
Okay, now one last thing. If you are working with Premiere and you want to insert the sound from the H2N, you might need to run it through the conversion once before. If Premiere inserts the H2N sound on 4 separate tracks, it means that Premiere is not recognizing it as ambisonic. Alright, see you in the next videos.